Children, I heard about what happened at school today. Now, none of you took that nasty marijuana, did you?
No, dude, we never even saw it.
Okay, because I just want to tell you that drugs are bad.
We know. That's what everybody says.
Right. But do you know why they're bad?
Because they're an addictive solution to a greater problem causing disease of both body and mind with consequences far outweighing their supposed benefits.
And do you have any idea what that means?
No.
I know. Drugs are bad because if you do drugs, you're a hippie, and hippies suck.
Look, children, this is all I'm going to say about drugs. Stay away from them. There's a time and a place for everything, and it's called college. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, are you going to come to Ike's Bris this weekend?
Oh, hell no. I can't bear to see that.
What do you mean?
Don't you boys know what a bris is? They're going to circumcise him.
What's that?
Oh, boy. Here we go again. Children, what's the one thing that's more sacred to a man than anything else in the world?
Bicycles?
Ham?
No, not ham, you fat f***.
Screw you! It's ham, isn't it?
No, children. I'm talking about the most important part of a man's body.
Your heart?
Your eyes.
Oh, your tongue.
That's right.
Aye, my mom says you're not supposed to call it a penis, Kenny. You're supposed to call it a fireman.
A fireman?
That's the proper way to say it, or else you get a spanking.
Damn it, children. Why do I always have to be the one to explain all this stuff to you? Ask your parents for once.
Hey, wait!
Oh, children, it'll be glorious.
So, Captain Ahab has to get his way, huh?
Dude, what does that mean?
Hey, isn't that kid Kevin Chinese?
Yeah, you're from China.
No, I'm from America. My parents are Chinese.
Tell us how the Chinese play dodgeball.
I have no idea, dude.
Come on, rice picker.
Hey, children, that's not cool. You don't make fun of somebody because of their ethnicity.
You don't? But, Chef, you just ripped on Chinese people.
No, that's different. I made fun of them because they are from China. You see, it's not okay to make fun of an American because they are black, brown, or whatever, but it is okay to make fun of foreigners because they are from another country.
Yeah.
Hello there, children.
Hey, Chef. What you doing?
Children, this whole film festival thing has quite lucrative monetary possibilities. Now, I'm going to sell some of my famous cookies to these Hollywood types and make a mint.
What kind of cookies?
Calm down, Tubby.
They're little cookies with fudge in the middle, and I call them fudgeums.
I want a fudgeum.
I can just see the commercial now. Wife got you down, boss making you angry, kids yelling at you. Well, fudgeum.
Cool.
And I've also got my double chocolate cookies. Fudge this.
Oh, look, one of the natives is selling local food wares. How quaint.
This is why I come to these things, to get away from L.A. and become one with a more simple culture.
Well, perhaps you'd like to try my low-calorie cookies. Go fudge yourself. On my all-natural, I don't really give a flying fudge.
Ooh, do you have any tofu or steamed celery?
Huh? I would kill for some couscous right now.
Whose goose?
Never mind. We brought some food from the natural market in L.A.
Cute sign, though.
Get them while they're hot. My all-new cookies. I just went and fudged your mama.
Jesus, he sure ran that one into the ground.
Say, everybody, have you seen my balls? They're big and salty and brown. If you ever need a pick, pick me up. Just stick my balls in your mouth. Ooh, suck on my chocolate salty balls.
Put them in your mouth.
Put them in your mouth and suck them and suck them.
I'll never forget you. You were my best friend after Stan.
Come on, Kyle. It's time to go.
Chef, does Pooh go to heaven?
Well, I kind of hope not. I mean, sure it does. Here, I'll give him one of my salty balls to take with him to Pooh heaven. Come on, let's go.
Mr. Hanky?
My salted chocolate balls must have rejuvenated here.
You got the best balls in the whole world, Chef.
You're damn right.
What's happening here, Terrence?
We're doing an anal transplant. It's our only hope.
Who's the donor?
I am, Philip. I am.
Terrence, you're giving up your ass for me?
Just half my ass. Can you believe it, Philip? Here we are, best friends, and now we're going to share the same ass.
Oh, damn it. Not now. Damn it. Children, what are you doing here? Terrence and Philip are about to go into surgery.
Chef, we want to know about herpes.
What makes you think I would know anything about that?
I don't know. You're just the only grown-up we trust. How does someone get herpes?
Well, you get it by sharing relations with somebody who already has it. You have to be very careful around someone who has herpes.
You know anybody with herpes?
Well, there's old Frida down on Main Street. She has a mouthful of herpes. You need to stay away from her.
But what if we want to give somebody herpes?
Oh, then Frida's the right person to go to.
Cool. Thanks, Chef.
Okay. Wait a minute. What the hell did I just do?
Hey, Stan, do you know how to play Truth or Dare?
No.
Well, dude, how the hell are we supposed to play it then?
I didn't even think about that.
And then they'll ask Truth or Dare.
And I say Dare.
No, no. You say Truth.
Truth? But that's boring. I want to get Dared to kiss her.
You have to say Truth the first few times, or else you seem too eager.
Oh.
You can't seem too eager. You got to play it cool, like you don't even care what happened.
Yeah.
Then after a few truths, you finally answer Dare.
Dare.
But not like that, son. Like this. Dare.
Oh.
And then her little friend will dare you to kiss Wendy.
You really think so?
Of course she will. They're women. They've had this whole thing planned out months ahead of time.
Wow.
Stinky Britches, you got those Stinky Britches.
So you see, Mr. Beak record producer, Stinky Britches was something I wrote several years ago.
I really see no resemblance between that song and Stinky Britches by our artist Alanis Morissette.
Huh?
It's the same goddamn song!
Now look, I'm trying to be cool about this, but you can't just rip people's music off. It's against the law.
I am above the law!
Thank you, Chef.
No problem, Miss Blaflowski. Now about that $100?
Of course. Here you go. Leaving so soon?
I got a long way to go to raise the kind of money I need.
Well, best of luck to you then.
How was it, honey?
Pretty much what I expected.
All right, let's get this show on the road. Come here, baby!
Hold on a second, Miss Crabtree. How would you like to use some sex toys?
Sex toys? Like what?
Like this very special device. I call it Chef's Pleasure Bag.
How does it work?
Now, all you do is put this paper bag over your head, and it increases your sexual pleasure.
Really? Well, hell, let's give it a shot.
Ah, yeah, that's much better. Hello there, children.
Hey, Chef.
All ready for a Halloween lunch? Today I've got spooky spaghetti with freaky french fries.
Chef?
Or haunted hash browns.
Chef?
And a creepy cookie and monstrous milk.
Chef?
And a terrifying napkin.
Chef!
What?
We have problems.
Well, what's the first problem?
Chef, I have a goldfish that keeps killing people.
Oh, well, don't worry, Stan. I'm sure it'll work out. Now, what's the other problem? Oh, no. Oh, dear God, no!